Good evening. I am Ronald Regan, speaking for General Electric. Tonight from Hollywood, it is my pleasure to appear in a story entitled The Dark, Dark Hours. Young James Dean, one of the bright new actors in Hollywood, appears with me, and Constance Ford plays my wife on the General Electric Theater.
You the doctor?
Yes.
We had an accident here.
Bring him in.
No, man. The doc's gonna take a look. I'm sorry, man. Here. Say hello to the doctor, Pee-wee.
Hello to the doctor.
All right, bring him right down here.
Sorry, man. Easy.
In here.
Going too fast?
No. All right, let's get him up on the table.
Man, this
is bad. One of those paper, man.
Huh? Make sure he's got a paper. But don't let him cut me, man, unless he's got a paper.
Okay, man, I got you.
Get his coat off.
Make sure it's got a stamp on it.
Skin it, baby.
Like, don't let him cut me, you know? Make sure it's got a stamp on the paper.
What's the trouble?
Pee-wee wants to know you got a paper.
What?
A paper, Dad. A paper, you know? You go to school and they give you a paper, don't they? Well, let's see.
You mean my license?
Yeah, that's what he means. I'm suspicious, Dad. I trust you. I don't trust Bud here. I figure maybe he'd take me to a quack or something.
All right, let's see the paper. Show him the paper. Come on, man. Oh, crazy. License to practice. I've got a stamp.
He's a cat, man. Okay, Dad, practice.
That's a bullet wound. Where'd you get that?
From a gun, man. Where are you going?
To the phone.
Well, it was like we were hunting, and like this little bunny.
Yeah, sure, I know.
Look, Dad, I like you. I don't want no ordinary bones to pick over me, so I decided I want you to do it. You don't want to call nobody.
I'm sorry. I have to call the police. That's the law.
law. We break those all the time, don't we, Bob?
Oh, I guess we broke them maybe 10 tonight. One more's not gonna hurt, Doc.
Look, boys, I don't know what you've done.
Oh, no, Doc. Now, you take out that bullet and stop talking.
I'm not a surgeon.
Well, fake it, Dad.
What?
Do the best you can. You dig me?
I can't. I'm alone here. I'd have to have some help.
Oh, man.
Hey, squad. Maybe he wants the sheriff to hold the light.
I can't do it alone.
You're going to play this one solo, man.
You wanted to die?
Die? Okay. But'll help you. Well, man, I got to cover this cat. You married, Doc?
Now, listen.
Now, what's a wife for if she can't help you once in a while?
Take it easy, boys. Don't push me too far.
Go get his wife, bud. Hurry up, will you?
I'll get her.
That's nice. I can go along, too, huh, Doc?
Hey, man, get me a radio, will you? Like, I need some music. Okay. I need something.
Now, look, son.
Don't call me son.
Do you want your friend to live or not?
He'll live, Doc. He better live.
Well, then you'd better get into a hospital, because believe me, he's liable to die.
No. Hey, Doc. This your wife, Doc? Hey. How's a guy like you get such a good-looking doc? Huh? Huh? Where'd you get this chick? You dig her? Huh?
Hey.
Don't be afraid, honey.
What do you want here?
His friend has a bullet in him. We have to take it out.
What do you mean, we have to take it?
I'll need some help.
Well, I can't help you. You know that.
Wait a minute. What do you mean you can't help?
It's true.
I can't. That's all I do.
She can't stand the sight of blood, son.
Don't call me son. Now, you pick up on that right now.
Now, let her stay here. I don't need her.
Come on, let's get in there.
Oh, now, Joe.
Come on. Get in there.
You better do it, honey.
That's nice, Doc. Where's the radio? My friend likes music.
There's one in the bedroom.
No.
Joe, what is the matter with you? Let a kid like that come into our house in the middle of the night and push us around? You act as though you're afraid of him.
What do you want me to do, be a hero? He's got a gun.
Well, so he's got a gun. He's only...
Come on, man. What are you doing out here? Playing a house? Let's go. Come on. Come on, sweetie. Come on. That's nice.
We'd better hurry.
I'm hip. Hey, Pops. Hey. Hey, man.
Come on in, man.
Hey, where'd I plug this in? Crazy Pee Wee has a little bop. He's gonna be good as new. Crazy.
Look, Betty, you'll have to hold this, and when I start probing for the bullet, I want you
Joe,
to keep some...
Joe, now listen, when you start to operate, he'll be off.
No.
I can just throw this in his face and you grab the gun.
No, Betty.
Joe, he's only a baby, a child. You can't let him walk around with that gun in his hand.
That's not my problem. My problem is saving that boy's life. This is no time for heroics.
Here. Joe, I simply do not understand. Now, listen. Those boys are dangerous. You can't let him walk out of this house with a license to kill.
We have a lot of fun.
Why don't you just close your eyes and pretend nothing's happening?
Pick up on that, man?
Crazy.
Huh? It's crazy, isn't it?
He's swinging.
Joe.
Betty, what do you want me to do? I'm not a policeman. I'm a doctor. The boy has a bullet in him. My job is to take it out, period, the end. Let somebody else play policeman.
All right. Then I'll do it alone.
I won't let you.
Let her what?
Help me. The last time she watched an operation, she passed out cold.
Crazy.
No. It's all right. I want to. You better get started.
If I were you, I wouldn't do anything funny. You know what I mean? Huh? You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Look at that. Stay with me.
Can you just lie back? Well, she's going to hold this under your nose, and you just breathe deeply.
What?
I can't take a chance on a general without oxygen. It's just a little chloroform.
Oh, no, man. No eyes to sleep. You give me a needle. You got some kind of needle there, don't you?
It'll hurt that way.
I've been hurt before. Hey, Bud, if I scream, man, you turn that radio up good and loud, huh? So nobody hears me.
Don't hit that. Don't hit that.
Don't you want to come over here where you can watch?
Hey, Pee-wee, did you pick up on that? Yeah. She's real friendly.
Sounds like a crusader to me, man.
No, she's friendly.
Betty.
They're all crusaders, man.
Betty.
You really think so, Pee-wee? Oh, lady, what do you want to be a crusader for?
Huh? What do we cats ever do to you? Huh? You take the doc here. He's a real swinger. Aren't you, Doc? You don't ask no questions. You just go about your business. See, that's how come Doc's gonna stay alive. He's gonna stay real healthy. That is, if Pee-wee stays healthy. Of course, I know that Doc wouldn't do anything crazy. If anything would happen to Pee-wee...
He's in bad shape. I can't guarantee anything.
Well, you better, Doc. You really better.
All right, Doc. Don't hurt that cat. You make it smooth. You dig that?
What's the matter, lady? Huh? What, you getting sick already?
Huh? Very sick.
Must be the place.
We better get started.
And now, Act Two of The Dark, Dark Hour, starring Ronald Regan with James Dean and Constance Ford.
How you making, Pops?
Man, I feel like I'm floating.
Yeah, me too. It's crazy, isn't it? Crazy. How's it gonna be, Doc? How's he, Doc? Hey, how are you, man? Huh? How you doing, Pops?
Man.
Huh? You making it? Let's just pick up on that bop. That's all you have to do.
Turn up that music.
We'd better get him to a hospital.
Why?
He's lost a lot of blood. He needs a transfusion.
Well, give it to him.
I don't have the equipment. Come on, help me get him to the car.
What, are you crazy, Dad?
Well, do you want him to die?
I can't go to no hospital.
You don't have to go. Just help me get him to the car.
Now, wait a minute. Now, let's just keep it cool, man. Just don't mess around.
Well, now, look, if we're not in a... Turn off that radio. If we don't hurry, there's no use in going.
Come on, man. Hey. Come on, Phoebe. How you feel, Pops? How are you? Huh? You want to go to the hospital? Man, that's a drag. He doesn't want to go to the hospital, Doc. Hey, come on, man. Get up. Let's cut out.
Look,
here.
I'm not going to argue with you. If he doesn't have a transfusion, he's going to die. It might be too late right now.
Come on, man.
Either help me or get out of the way.
Wait a minute! You're getting me mixed up. Now, let's keep it
Take his feet.
Cool.
Take his feet. All right, now be careful. Come on, now, easy.
Get back there! Go on, get back there! What's the matter with you? Now, we're just going to stay right here, all of us, until Pee-wee's back on his feet. Hey, man. Hey, Pee-wee. Hey, man. You okay? Hey, come on. Come on, Dad. Pick it up. Pick up the bones. Come on. Come here, Doc. I don't like the way he looks.
He's dead.
Well, you're lying.
Look for yourself.
Hey, Pee-wee. Don't goof on me now.
Well, Pee-wee, you're not dead. What'd you kill him for? He was all right. Oh, man, what am I gonna do with this idea? Man, come on, don't kid with me, huh? Come on. Come on, man. Get up. What am I gonna do, man? Huh? No one gives a thing whether I live or die except you, man. Come on. I'm scared. Don't leave me alone. What did he do to you? You killed him. You killed him. You killed him.
Stop it. Sit down and
I'm going to kill you, both of you.
You shouldn't have done that. What
am I going to do?
Are you satisfied now, Doctor? I'm going to call the police.
Patty.
What are you doing? Get away from there. Come on. Hey, you got to give us time to get away, see? Come on, man. We're going to cut out of here. We don't want to bother you, honest. We don't know. Give us a half hour, I promise. Come on, man. We don't want to kill you, honest, we don't. Do we, man? Huh? Come on. You've got to give us time to get away. Come on.
Oh, sure. He'll give you the time. He may even give you some money. He might give you the car. Because, you see, you're not his problem. He's no policeman. He's a doctor.
What's that?
Nobody.
Who's in there?
I'll put you back to bed.
Wait a minute. Doc, she's going to get herself hurt. You know that.
You'd better get out of here.
I don't have to listen to you. I don't have to listen to nobody. This is a gun, man. I'm a big man. Take a good look at it. I'm a big man.
I want you to get out of this house, and I want you to get out right now.
Look, Doc, you're a swinger. I can trust you, but you get them crusaders around. And how do I know that when I leave here, she's not going to pick up the phone? No, man, I need protection. Now, come on. Come on. Oh, look at this great big room they got for such a tiny little baby.
Hey, Pee-wee, man, you ought to see. They got things all over the walls in here. It's great. How about that, huh?
Oh, will you get out of here?
I bet you like that little kid, don't you? Huh? I bet you love her, don't you? And my old lady loved me, too, I bet. Only I didn't get no big room like this or nothing. She didn't care whether I got hurt or nothing like I bet you do about her, huh? I don't know. Maybe I'm not supposed to have nothing. I don't even care, but if I can't be the best, I'm gonna be the worst, huh? And I'm gonna tell you one thing. No one's gonna look at me again like I'm a piece of dirt.
Leave her alone.
I got the gun, not you.
That's only a .32. It's not a very big bullet.
I'm not gonna hurt her, Doc. I just gotta make sure.
You gotta be lucky. And if you're lucky, very lucky, then you've killed another man.
It's just alone, Doc. It's just alone. That's all. I'm gonna let her go, and you can pick her up in half an hour, huh?
But if you're not lucky, that bullet isn't gonna stop me.
No good, Doc.
I want you to take your hands off my wife and get out of this house.
Get out of the way.
Sure. I'll get out of the way. But you're going out of here alone, Sonny.
Don't you call me Sonny! Now you got 5 seconds to get out of the way. One!
I'm telling you for the last time, if you go out of here, you're going out alone.
Two!
Look at my mommy!
It's all right, Susie. Everything's gonna be all right.
Three!
Look at my mommy!
I'm not afraid of you!
I don't know whether to beat you or kill you. Oh, you. You never did get the idea, did you? Did you think for one minute that I was afraid of you? I did everything you asked because I wanted to get you out of here. I didn't want my family getting hurt by a vicious little pup like you. No, you had to be a big man with a gun. Well, your friend in there is dead because of you. How big does that make you feel?
Hit me. Why don't you hit me?
Because if I started, I don't think I could stop.
Oh, man.
Joe. I'm sorry, Joe. I'm so sorry.
I better call the police. Well, I hope you enjoyed James Dean and Constance Ford and the rest of us in the dark, dark hours. And now I'd like to tell you something about the shows coming up. Next week, we start the first of three very special programs we've arranged for over the holidays. And the first one next week is Fred Waring and the Pennsylvanians in Music for Christmas. And I know that many of you know those traditional Christmas shows of Fred Waring's and will want to be on hand. And while the most of you will have to see it at home in your own television sets in black and white, it will be our first color telecast on the General Electric Theater. And the week following, that will be 2 weeks from tonight, we present Barry Fitzgerald and Dan O'Herlihy in a wonderful play called The White Steed by the noted and celebrated Irish playwright Paul Vincent Carroll. So until next Sunday at the same time, good night for General Electric.